Let me also get your view in, Krishna, in terms of how you're looking at the recent developments as well, the dependence that we have traditionally seen on China and how things are likely to change going forward. What are some of the issues before we can actually think about self-reliance in API? Policy support has come, but do you think that there is more that's needed constructively to make this a reality?
The policy has been announced, but basically I've been going through the details. Much more details are required. However, from what I understand, the government is trying to promote smaller units. They want to distribute the requirement of India into four or five people, four or five companies, and that will make it small. And going forward, for especially intermediates, I think India needs to focus more on intermediates than APIs. And these intermediates have to be made on scale and with different technologies than what others make. Chinese plants have been set up ages ago, and today India is capable of coming out with better technologies. We as Granules have been doing a lot of research for about 5, 6 years on new technologies, green technologies, continuous manufacturing. However, the scale was daunting us and the investments. If you really, like, let's take a product like a PAP, which is the key intermediate for paracetamol. Entire India is dependent on China, one way or other. There are some companies which make their own PAP, but again, that is from an intermediate where we are mainly dependent on China again. It doesn't really help. You need to go back all the way to benzene if you have to be more efficient. And these type of plants are mostly chemical plants than pharmaceutical plants. Pharmaceutical industry has to learn this type of manufacturing. It's a different ballgame altogether. So scale and investment have been holding us back so far. But however, today we have decided that the time has come. We will go ahead. And I hope the government will change their policy of distributing this into smaller companies. In my opinion, for each product, there should not be more than two or three companies in the world, and the best wins. And that's how the efficiencies come in. And also, like the previous speaker had said, it's not just India. We need to also spread across. We also have plans of going in for very clean API manufacturing in the Western world. We are working on it. And in the next few years, I think we are going to have exciting times. India is going to have exciting times. India is capable of coming out with these greener technologies, efficient technologies. It's going to be exciting. And with a little push and help from the government, things are going to go smooth.
Right. So, Darshan, what is your own sense? You think the policy support is enough, or do you think more needs to be done to try and encourage self-reliance within APIs?
The policy support doesn't really help much. It's a push. That's what we are getting. But just depending on the incentive scheme of the government, I don't think we can set up those high-level, high-volume continuous manufacturing plants. Industry should put in the money today, and the time has come. Industry has realized we need to do that. And it need not be just the pharmaceutical company which is putting up. There could be tie-ups with other chemical industries. There's so much chemistry capability, chemical engineering capability in India, and we need to tie up with partners and cooperate with each other and set up these type of facilities. One company cannot do all these things. Pharma should stick to pharma and cooperate with somebody else. If we have the technology, pass it on to somebody else, let them do what they are good at, and together we can win.
Could you give us a view, Krishna, as to what the outlook is in terms of the supply opportunities as well as exports?
There's tremendous opportunity today. And again, if we invest into the right technologies, cost-wise too, we will be better than what we had been in the past. The only issue is CapEx. Once we overcome the CapEx, the returns are going to be good. And the outlook is very, very bright. And again, I have to warn everybody here, if we don't move fast as in Indian industry and as a country, it's not competition from China. It's going to be competition from the West. France is going to set up plants, Italy will set up plants, even APIs and some intermediates. So we need to move fast. And outlook, like I said, is very exciting. And there are exciting times ahead as long as we are nimble-footed and we move fast. And government support is needed, but just depending on government support to do this is not going to work.